Warning: The following argument is not predicated on claims or knowledge. Only rational arguments are presented to expose blatant contradictions in creationist theory. This is done by or under the supervision of professionals, and you should in no way attempt to recreate or reenact these arguments with religious folk because it will greatly upset them. The first mistake that most people make when trying to argue against God is asking for a definition of God. This is irrational because God is traditionally assumed to be an object. Numbers chapter 12 verses 6 through 8 prove this, along with a few other Bible verses. It says that Moses speaks directly, mouth to mouth, with God, and that he has a form to behold. So we must keep in mind that it is irrational to define a specific object. Objects can only be objectively modeled or represented, never defined. Think of it this way. We may be able to define the concept of chairs as a category of things, but the individual chair itself that exists, that you are sitting on in this very moment, can only be objectively modeled and presented or illustrated. Objects in reality are not defined, but rather their shape is presented objectively through some form of objective modeling. On a related side note, if you do wish to claim that God is a concept like love or justice, then you have already automatically disqualified God from existence, since concepts do not exist in reality. But anyway, the rational way to argue against God is to let the priest present his God, rather than jumping down his throat, so that he can dig his own grave by proving to everybody in the audience that he has no idea what he is talking about. So let's imagine that the priest follows tradition and presents an old white man with a beard, and he calls him God. God seems like a good enough name as any for an old white man, and he's easy to follow and understand in this stage, even if we already have some questions about this assumption. It is the next stage, however, where he tries to pull the rabbit out of his hat, and you can expose his contradiction. This is the part where he will tell you that God created the heavens and the earth. In other words, God created matter and space from nothing. Now, you can create an omelet with some eggs, or you can create a smoothie with a blender, but each of these requires that the action is performed by something that already exists. Creation of something from nothing is the proposition that nothing can be acted upon, or that nothing can perform some action. And anybody who considers this for more than 2 seconds can see that this is absurd. If nothing is the actor in your theory, then you have presented an inconceivable contradiction. Actions can only ever impart through and upon objects in reality. And this is really the greatest magic trick of all time. The priest is fundamentally telling you, nothing happened, nothing transformed, God acted upon nothing, and nothing became. And yet, it fills the believer's head with the most wild and fantastic thoughts, full of shapes, colors, and imagery. Truly incredible. Thank you for watching.